Hello, beautiful. I hope you're having an amazing day. Today, I am very excited to talk to you because I'm going to be talking to you about one of my favorite subjects, which is plant medicine. And I'm more specifically going to be talking to you about how to identify if you are being called to plant medicine, because this is often a phrase or a term that's used when people are following their curiosities or inkling or nudges to the alternative forms of healing, such as psychedelics like ayahuasca. So let's get started. If you guys are new to the channel, my name is Zoe and I'm so happy to have you here. I absolutely love to speak about spirituality and self-improvement, and I actually have a full series on my experiences with plant medicine such as ayahuasca. So I'll be leaving that down below if it's something that you are interested in, because for me personally, I never thought that I would be someone who would dabble in plant medicine or like psychedelics or drugs by any means, because that's a term that's sometimes used to describe these types of substances. But I did it, and it was one of the most healing, liberating things I could have ever done for myself. It probably was the best thing I ever did for myself, was to take ayahuasca, because it was able to heal me in ways that different forms of healing could not do for me. And you can check out that series to learn more about what it personally healed for me and my journey through life. But today I'm going to speak more about the call to plant medicine. So you cannot perceive what you are not in the vibration of. So the fact that you did click onto this video could be sign enough for you that yes, you are being called to plant medicine. But I'm going to describe how the call shows up for me, and hopefully then you can pinpoint maybe some similarities or some synchronicities in your own life and be more open to that and be more open to the guidance that you may be receiving in this time. So for me personally, like I said, I never thought that I was someone who would do plant medicine, do ayahuasca. I was very much like this goody two shoes stereotype through my life. Quiet, a little bit shy. I was outgoing in high school and things like that, but I never drank in high school. I never had this party phase in my life. I was always just focused on doing my best and focused on learning and growing and avoiding any type of substances. And what happened for me was, as I was on this journey of self-improvement, seeking more, seeking truth, and as I began to wake up, like waking up in regards to a spiritual journey, a spiritual path, I had so many questions about the universe and how it operates. I was getting very good at manifestation. I was understanding and consuming content and really enjoying absorbing all of that, like a little spiritual sponge. But what it felt like in my life was that there was something that I wasn't getting. Almost like everyone knew a secret, or some people who I was looking up to in life, like maybe that's Oprah or other spiritual leaders, spiritual teachers, and I'm like, I feel like they know something that I don't know. And I was yearning for that information. Like, what are we all doing here? And if you clicked on this video, you've probably had those thoughts cross your mind too. Like, what are we all doing here on planet Earth? Why? What's the purpose? How does it operate the way that it does? Why do bad things happen? And for me, I was drawn to plant medicine in a time when I was living in Rome, and people who were very, very influential in my life passed away, and I couldn't understand why a bad thing would happen to such beautiful, bright lights in this world. And throughout that year, I had gotten these signs or these little synchronicities about this plant from the Amazon called ayahuasca, which I had never heard about before in my entire life. I've been on the spiritual path, I'd watch all sorts of different spiritual YouTube videos and things like that, and I'd never come across the term ayahuasca or what that meant. And so it presented itself in the way that I was at a self-improvement conference in London, England, and I met this guy, and he just started talking to me about how he just got back from Peru and he had done this magical tea with a shaman called ayahuasca, and I was, tell me more. My curiosity was opening up. And then I got back to Rome, and one of my friends got back from Brazil, and she said, you know, I was in Brazil and I did this thing called ayahuasca. Talking to me about the experience, I'm like, tell me more. I was seeking truth, and I felt very called. You know, when somebody is talking and something sparks your interest, your curiosity starts to fire, and so I'm like, okay, gotta keep learning more. So after that, I just kept hearing about it. started to see some YouTube stuff pop up, started to just, you know, hear about it in the ways of people's conversations or what was in my vibration. So this is what I'm talking about at the beginning of this video. And I said, you cannot perceive what you're not in the vibration of. I was not aware of ayahuasca, but once I became aware that this could be something that's calling me, the synchronicity started to occur. And I was going through a sort of a dark night of the soul, very conflicted in what was next for me in my life, and very much feeling like I'd hit this ceiling. I'd done all this personal work, read all the books, doing all these things, but I had these deeper questions about how the universe operates, and I was seeking answers. I was seeking answers as to why I'm not where I want to be, and I felt energetically, so this was something that I was beginning to understand, was thinking in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration, and me personally, and how do I go about raising my vibration when I felt like something was heavy inside and I couldn't identify what it was. Then Rhythmia reached out, Rhythmia Life Advancement Center, where I've gone to do ayahuasca twice, done a total of 8 ceremonies there. And they invited me for a media trip. And I looked at it and I saw ayahuasca, plant medicine ceremonies. I'm like, okay, whoa, synchronicities. I'm someone who's very like, I always believe the universe is communicating to us. It always is, it's always our mirror. So I'm like, okay, I have to say yes. It's not a matter of if I'm scared or if I'm gonna do more research. Like, this keeps popping up for me, and this just feels right. So I accepted a media deal with Rhythmia, and that was, you know, a complimentary trip for me to create YouTube videos and content about ayahuasca. I had a very specific deal about 3 videos is all that I was supposed to produce, but you guys have seen I produced a lot more than that because it was healing, because I just feel compelled to share. This video then in its sense is not sponsored whatsoever. I just received such a beautiful experience from it that's why I want to share it with you. And you can do ayahuasca all over the world. So, you know, just if you start to become more curious, you'll notice that there are many opportunities and many places that you can go. So I decided to get on that plane, go to Costa Rica from Rome, and I went there to the jungle with a bunch of strangers, didn't know anyone. My dad thought ayahuasca was a hike before, like a couple weeks before I told him that I was going to do ayahuasca. Like, I'm like, do you know what ayahuasca is? No. Told him, you know. So I was nervous, I was hesitant, but the draw was stronger than my own mind, my logical thinking brain. The spiritual draw was stronger than like the reasons why I was trying to make up why I should or shouldn't do it. And so I found myself in ayahuasca. I remember thinking before the ceremony happened, you know, we met Jerry, who I've done an interview with my channel. Like, the whole experience there was very welcoming and very loving. So that's why I just felt like safe. I was in this safe place and it was okay to drink the medicine. So the first night I remember being so excited to try it. I'm like, I'm ready. I'm ready for my experience. I know that I was called, like, just took a day for me to really get into that groove and really get into the place of the plants, that I knew that this was next for me. So upon taking that first drink and the drinks onward, the ceremonies onward, like I said, you can go watch that series. It was super transformative for me, and I share very vulnerably with you. But I knew that I was called. And yeah, it was very, very beautiful, very healing, more than I could ever imagine. And I broke through that ceiling. I broke through the energies. I broke through ancestral patterns. I did all the healing that I was called to do in that time. And the visions that I saw in ayahuasca were not of my lifetime, just my lifetime. And that's where deep breakthrough healing happened for me. So if you do feel a call, if you are watching this video, I'm here to confirm that you are being called, and not just ayahuasca, for example. So more recently in my life, I've been called to psilocybin. And it's very interesting because I have done a couple psilocybin type ceremonial experiences, and I've had healing come through. It's a much lighter healing than I would say ayahuasca is. Ayahuasca can be very frightening or very confronting for people, but I promise you it always ends in love. It always ends in love, especially if you're at a place like Rhythmia, which is literally a slice of heaven. And so, you know, different plants communicate with you. And so I'm here to tell you that, like, you're not crazy. The plants are talking to you. I have lots of plants in my house. You know, herbs can speak to you too. So for me personally, something that I like to do is to make my own teas with things like dandelion root or red clover or nettle. I just get little inklings like, okay, make your womb tea. This is like a feminine tea that my friend Manisha, who's a herbalist, had recommended to me before. I'll wake up and I'll know what tea I need. And then I'll just mix it up, mix all the little herbs, and I'll just feel a lot more relaxed or a lot more centered. So be open to the communication of the plants and just honor that. You're not crazy. I'm here to tell you you're not crazy. If you feel like Mother Ayahuasca has come to you in your dreams or you're having these synchronicities, you're not crazy. It's there for a reason. If you feel the same way, if you feel curious about dabbling in psilocybin because you heard that it can help you with anxiety or depression, follow those curiosities. Do your own research. Feel into it and feel if it is something that you would try. Because there is such beautiful wisdom in the plants. There is such beautiful knowledge, like you can't even imagine. I can't even put it into words, the healing, the things that I've seen, because it's beyond. It's beyond this physical experience. Think about plants in the terms of like of a consciousness, a plane of consciousness. Human beings are on one plane, you know, animals are there too. Plants have their own plane, rocks are another one. Plants have been here since the beginning of our world, right? Okay, Earth happened and plants started growing. There is a consciousness that the plants share. They all hold different frequencies and different vibrations, and upon ingesting those, we can tap into their knowledge. They've grown through time. There is a consciousness of the seasons. There is this consciousness that says, okay, springtime, like let's start blooming. There is a consciousness that is starts to trigger fall, leaves start falling. There's so much that we can learn from nature because nature brings us back to the simplicity of things. And so if you're feeling called to a specific plant, it's trying to communicate with you, it's trying to teach you something, it's trying to bring you back to your roots. Literally, it's trying to bring you to the roots of understanding the nature of life, that we are here to grow, bloom, and flourish, and at times that means letting go. But the trees, you don't see them freaking out when they're dropping their leaves in the fall because they know when they release what's no longer serving them, they bloom into something more beautiful. So trust the process, and trust that if you are feeling called, that this is the confirmation. Do your own research, like I said, feel into it, and decide if it's something that's for you. But but nothing but beautiful healing experiences with plants. So I hope this video helped you guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. If it did, my name is Zoe, and I'm also a life coach. So if you do feel like you have any questions or are seeking empowerment in the awakening or integration experience, please don't hesitate to reach out. I'm always taking on new clients if I have the capacity to. So sending you just a beautiful, abundant ray of sunshine, and I will see you again in my next video. Bye.